You're not even trying, Sherry. Concentrate. You're not even trying, Sherry. Concentrate. You're not even trying, Sherry. Concentrate.
In a fit of rage, the elephant broke the chain and threw its victim on the ground with a fierce power. Escaping the scene, it pulled the body with it but dropped it at the gate. At least some of this was witnessed by a third party who was hurled against the shed. The elephant can't have gone too far. I can still track it.
Well, suppose you find it. Then what? Push it all the way back to the manor?
May I ask you something?
That's a question I can answer.
May I ask you something?
I can't help you with that, sir.
Hey.
The elephant barged into this cart of olive oil.
What if we're lucky and he slipped and fell somewhere along the way?
Merhaba. İyiyim.
Are you able to help me?
I don't think I'm rich enough to talk to you, sir.
Can you satisfy my curiosity?
What are you trying to sniff around for? I know nothing.
Not bad.
This elephant is quite clumsy.
Sit down.
Okay, hear me out. If an elephant falls in the forest and there's no one around to...
John, no.
Oh, you're such a killjoy.
Want to go for a swim? Strange. It was hung with care. The game has escaped us, for now. We'll find a solution to the elephant problem later. Hog Heaven.
Why do I get the worst jobs?
This young lady has a childish interest for her age.
Gosh, what a mansion.
I can always recognize the spirit of a true artist.
You! Who are you?
My name is Sherlock Holmes. Theodore Gildon was...
Did he kill him? Did he kill the elephant?
It's not in the yard anymore. It escaped into the forest.
You can't let it go. What if it returns?
I highly doubt that, Miss...
Imogen Gildon. Please, I beg of you, find that dreadful beast that killed my father.
I suppose we do need to learn what happened. Can you tell me what happened? From the very start.
I was here, so I didn't see how it began. My father visits the enclosure every morning to wake up Goliath. Today, I heard the elephant scream. I've never heard such a horrifying sound. My heart stopped. I knew something was wrong. I looked through my window and saw how it lifted my father up by his neck. I rushed downstairs. I saw it dragging my father as if he were a doll. I threw stones at it. It dropped my father's body and charged outside, screaming. Its roar was almost human. I was frightened, so I ran inside and hid here.
Well, it was the most probable outcome, living with a giant wild animal such as that.
How can you be so cold? Goliath murdered my father, Mr. Holmes. He mustn't be allowed to get away with it.
Well, thank you for the information, Miss Gildon. I did have some questions for your father. Perhaps you might help me with them?
I wasn't privy to much of my father's life, and it's very hard to think of anything at all with Goliath still loose. Please, Mr. Holmes.
Very well. Do you mind if I ask you more questions if I find anything that might help?
Anything to catch that monster!
Miss Gildon, I was on this island 10 years ago, and your father knew my mother. I believe I even had the opportunity to ride that balloon outside, but I do not recall seeing you.
I lived at my late mother's in Sheffield at the time. I'm in no spirit to reminisce right now. The elephant is out there.
You've never heard the name Violet Holmes before? Perhaps your father...
Please, Mr. Holmes, with that beast roaming free, I can't think of anything.
Very well. I have to leave you for now. I have to leave you for now. Nicest spot in the room. Mr. Gildon spent hours of his life right here.
Staring at an elephant's backside. What a wonderful life. Looks eccentric and smells eccentric.
What's so special about this place? Another elephant? Partnership annulled with a single stroke of a pen. A catchy title. I should take a photograph of the plans. I don't want to carry them around. A relatively functional choice to replace the finger. Oh, the pungent stench of an animal.
Did Theodore seek some pink elephants with this?
I think Miss Gildon has barely matured. I think they were closer than you and me, John.
I'm hurt.
Mother. It's nice to see her young and smiling. From before Mycroft was born, our family loves to prod at the past.
Holmes's desire to rake up the past is hereditary.
His second child, an apparent son and heir, I'd say. A. Swift, is this name familiar to you? Your father had it removed from this plan.
Oh, that's Arthur Swift. I've seen him a couple of times here. He works with my father in the old city, digging up something ancient.
He is an archaeologist?
That's the word, yes. But to be truthful, I really don't think Mr. Swift is fit to be one. I've just learnt a lot about archaeology from my favourite book series. Oh, they are page turners.
Inspirational, I'm sure, but would you happen to know where this Mr. Swift might be found?
I don't, but perhaps you can find out somewhere. My father's work with him is all official. Lots of boring legal papers with signatures and stuff.
I have to leave you for now. Had Goliath been aggressive before?
It's dangerous, but it was never aggressive near my father. My father would do anything for Goliath. All the elephant had to do was clap its ears.
You envied him, the elephant, I mean?
Our house is called the House of Ivory. I've heard some people refer to me as the Ivory Girl, and my room stinks of the animal, as if it's me who lives in a pen and not Goliath. It's not envy, Mr. Holmes. It's just incredibly difficult to live like this.
Did you observe anyone else in the yard? Any of your servants, perhaps?
Servants? Do you imagine that we would have any with Goliath? No one wishes to work in this house, even for double pay. I didn't see anyone else. Only my father and that diabolical beast.
I have to leave you for now.
Who's a cute bird?
The finest clothes for the finest people on the island.
You'll never find such magnificent paintings anywhere else. Just take a look.
My goods will brighten up your house. Enjoy your purchase.
A contest for the guests of Cordona. Find hidden treasure.
Have you found anything helpful?
I'll be right here. With your love for archives, you would have made the perfect bureaucrat. I'll be right here.
I remember the monument, Cordona's legendary pirate, the Robin Hood of the place. Do you recall it, John?
I do. I wonder if... What is that?
From day to night, Aidan stands there, recruiting... Rebellious workers for the day. From day to night, Aidan's... From day to night... You're being an eyesore. No entry for you.
Yes.
May I ask you something?
Why should I care about your troubles when you don't care about mine?
Don't pass by. Welcome, welcome.
Nasılsın?
The Market Square, beating heart of the old city.
Well, I wonder if they still sell that heavenly Turkish delight down the corner.
Nice affordable clothes. Step right up. Don't miss out on my unique clothes.
Stop blocking the view. Stop blocking the view.
Sir, kind sir, might I steal your attention?
I'm not buying.
Ah, that is the thing. You won't waste a single mangir. I am a digger, you see, and I have heard of a dig site so deep it clogs your ears. I want to be there.
Why are you telling me this?
I have heard of a man recruiting for such a dig. A man with a scar, such as the one that you're hiding. And your boots are dirty with the deep clay I am so familiar with. Oh, I hope it wasn't too rude of me to point that out.
You have a good eye. And you just want to dig? Dig deep and that's it? What's the catch? Are you in desperate need of money?
Oh, there is no catch, sir. I won't even ask for advance pay. Just give me a shovel and I'll dig a hole like you've never seen.
Huh. Is that so? Well, I have to ask you an important question first. Would you be fine working for Brits?
I am all for them.
Well, you say that, but can you prove it?
I'll sing you a very special song. God save our gracious queen.
Cut it! Or people here will make you their queen.
I can also speak in limericks.
Please don't. You might be a little bit weak in the head, but a natural bone digger with a keen eye is what we need. Take this permission slip and go to this address. The guard will let you in and check with the professor once you're there.
Oriental rugs at a good price.
Merhaba. It's a good day for a purchase.
Don't hurry, we can bargain.
Stop loitering and get inside. Newcomer. Talk to the professor first. He's the old fellow with the glasses and the plans.
Where's the fire in your eyes? Where's the smile? I am sick and tired of seeing apathy among the new workers.
Sir, believe me, I do have the spark. I want to start work straight away. It's as important to me as it is to you.
Ah, that's the spirit. I'm on the verge of a great discovery.
How did you meet me?
Don't ask questions. You'll have to find the answers yourself. I'm not a nanny. I'm a busy man who is changing the course of history.
When was the last time you saw...
Young man, you're disappointing me. I'd like to see a bright career for you as the best digger on the island. Don't ruin it. We'll talk when you find something useful.
I am ready to work.
Splendid. Do you know what I am working on?
The ivory bats. Everyone is looking forward to the grand opening.
Who told you this nonsense? Why would you contaminate history with this base desire for leisure? We are looking for Vitus Lemonius's tomb. This is our goal, to find the artifacts of the early Roman Empire. Let's continue. I am Professor Swift. We have three rules here. Don't touch anything, always return the tools, and don't distract me unless you find something.
Sounds simple enough. Are you the only one in charge here, Mr. Swift?
Yes, I am the only one, and no one else. You hear anything other than that, it's a lie. People of your kind can have difficulty understanding who's in charge. Take a minute, memorize my face, and then get to work.
Oh, I will definitely take a closer look to memorize my superior. I wish I could be as passionate about something as you are, Mr. Swift. You value knowledge and dedication over everything else.
It's a long road, young man. A sharp eye and attention to detail are the only stepping stones along this path. You have to sacrifice everything you love for the larger prize.
Exactly. So much in life is superficial. I wish more people would understand.
I never heard a truer word, lad. folk will ignore what truly matters in life, and for what? Convenience.
Bold words indeed. I doubt that many scientists would be willing to support their bragging with fieldwork.
The academic world is full of restrictions. Our honorable professors are too afraid to dirty their hands. God forbid if they have a stain on their shirt. You can follow in my footsteps. You can start learning by returning to work. Show me what you can find.
Swift lost his temper when he learned what happened to the statue. Swift lost his temper when he learned.
Quite daunting to see how deep the dig is.
Is this familiar to you?
I like you, friend, but I can't help you.
Somehow the text remains legible. Let's see if I remember my Latin. A sickle for harvesting. The ancient Romans honored the seasons. A goddess? A mother? Someone's wife? There were four statues here originally.
I wonder what the three other statues look like.